Welcome all. It's a LMS program initiated by Department of Collegiate and Technical Education, Program Electronics and Communication Engineering, Semester 5th, Course Application of Electronics Engineering, Unit 1, Consumer Electronics, Session 7. Dear students, we had seen many household refrigerators, commonly called fridges, air condition, industrial freezers, etc. in day-to-day life. These machines are used to keep the things like vegetables, food items, drinks, medicines and environment cool compared to surrounding temperature. This cooling process is achieved by the machines called refrigerators or by the process called refrigeration. Now we'll discuss the topic called refrigeration. In this topic we'll discuss the following contents. First one is terminology, refrigeration system, role of electronics in refrigeration applications. Dear students, now we'll see terminologies which will be used in the refrigeration system. So usually we know heat always flows from hot bodies to cooler objects. See here. So this will flow the heat from higher temperature to lower temperature until temperatures are equal. So this is what the fundamental phenomena used in the refrigerator. Now we'll see terminologies used in the refrigerator. First one is refrigeration. Refrigeration is a process of removal of heat from a confined space so as to reduce its temperature below the surrounding temperature and maintain it in that temperature. This is what we call it as a refrigeration. Next terminology is refrigerant. The refrigerant is a heat carrying medium which absorbs heat from a low temperature system and delivers it to a higher temperature system, example CFC, fluorocarbon, HFC, hydrochlorocarbons, HCFC, hydrochlorocarbons, Next terminology is refrigerator. A refrigerator is a reverse heat engine or a heat pump which takes out heat from cold body and delivers it to hot body. These are all the terminologies which will be used in the refrigeration techniques. Now we will see one of the typical vapor compression refrigeration system which will be used in the air condition or refrigerator. The basic components involved in the vapor compression system is compressor. So this is what compressor, condenser, expansion valve, this is expansion valve and evaporator. Now we will see working of refrigeration system. Here, before the expansion valve, the refrigerant fluid is in the liquid state at a relatively high pressure and high temperature. After the refrigerant flows from expansion valve, it is at very low pressure and low temperature. Due to low pressure, a portion of the refrigerant is now in the vapor form. See, after passing through expansion valve, some of the refrigerant will be in liquid and vapor form. Now refrigerant flow through a evaporator where heat flows from fridge to refrigerant. The contents inside the refrigerator is at a relatively low temperature than that of refrigerant, so that refrigerant absorbs the heat, producing cooling effect inside the fridge. Then refrigerant boils and convert it into vapor because of it heat received in the vapor system. After leaving the evaporator, refrigerant will refrigerant is at a gas state at low pressure and low temperature. In order to use refrigerant again, it must be brought back to liquid state at a high pressure, which is achieved by passing through a compressor. After the compressor, refrigerant will be in vapor form at a high pressure and high temperature. To change refrigerant into a liquid state, it should be removed from it so that refrigerant is passed through a condenser where the heat from refrigerant flows to air, converting the refrigerant into a liquid state at high pressure and high temperature. The refrigerant has returned to its initial state at the expansion value. The above steps are repeated for refrigeration. So this is what the typical vapor compression refrigeration system working principle. Dear students, for best understanding of refrigeration process, we'll see one video.
Basic principle of refrigeration is simple. Just pass a colder liquid continuously around the object which is to be cooled. This will take heat out from the object. The whole refrigeration technology is after this: how to produce cold liquid continuously. We will see how this is achieved in this video. This is what inside a refrigerator. At the heart of the system is a simple device called throttling device. Cold liquid is produced with help of this phenomenon. In this case, throttling device is a capillary tube. For effective throttling at inlet, refrigerant should be high pressure liquid. Throttling device is an obstruction to the flow, which causes tremendous pressure drop. Due to drop in pressure, boiling point of refrigerant comes down and it starts evaporating. Heat required for evaporation comes within the refrigerant, so its temperature drops. If you check temperature across throttling device, you can notice this drop. Next phase is simple. Just pass this cold liquid over the body where you have to absorb heat. During heat absorption process, refrigerant further evaporates and transforms into pure vapor. So we have produced the required refrigeration effect. If we can take this low pressure vapor refrigerant to state before throttling process, that is high pressure liquid state, we will be able to repeat this process. So first step, let's raise the pressure. A compressor is introduced for this purpose. Compressor will raise the pressure back to its initial value. But since it is compressing gas along with pressure, temperature will also raise. It is unavoidable. Now the refrigerant is high pressure vapor. To convert it to liquid state, we are introducing another heat exchanger. This heat exchanger is fitted outside refrigerator, so it will liberate heat to the surroundings. Vapor will get condensed to liquid, and temperature will come down to normal level. So the refrigerant is back to its initial state again, high pressure liquid. We can repeat this cycle over and over for continuous refrigeration. This cycle is known as vapor compression cycle. You can note more details of refrigerator components here. To enhance heat transfer, both evaporator and condenser are having fins attached to it. Since evaporator is cooling the surrounding air, it is common that water will get condensed over it, forming frost. Frequent removal of frost is required to enhance heat transfer. Apart from raising pressure, compressor also helps maintain flow in the refrigerant circuit. Usually, hermetically sealed reciprocating type with proper sealing is used for this purpose. Since it is compressing gas, huge amount of input power is required for this operation. A simple energy balance of the system yields this relation. Performance of a refrigeration system can be defined as follows.
Dear students, now we'll see what exact role of electronics in refrigeration. In the mechanical control system, bimetal thermostat is used for temperature sensing and making compressor go on and off in such a way so as to maintain the temperature within a specified range. It works as per temperature by set by the user. Thermostat has its own limitations like fixed sensing mechanism and less accuracy. Due to this, these advantages can be overcome by using an electronic system has been introduced as shown in the figure. So this is what the electronic system which will be introduced in the refrigerator nowadays. In the electronic system, it contains a microcontroller, temperature sensors, user interface card and program logic. By this operation, we can make environmental friendly, smart and superior by sensing ambient temperature. So by using this electronic system, we can make refrigerations smart working. Nothing but it can sense the temperature according to the changes in the environment. Now we'll see applications of refrigeration. Refrigeration process can be used in the air condition of auditoriums, hospitals, residences, hotels, offices, etc. These refrigeration system can be used to preserve the medicines, nothing but blood and human tissues. The refrigeration can be used to store and transport the foodstuffs, manufacturing of ice, cooling of concrete for dams. So these are the few applications of refrigeration. These are the references which will be used to make the PPTs. Dear students, now we'll see some multiple choice questions regarding refrigeration. First question, the bank of tubes at back of domestic refrigerator is, options are condenser tubes, evaporator tubes, refrigerant cooling tubes, capillary tubes. So answer is condenser tube. In refrigeration cycle, the flow of refrigerant is controlled by options are compressor, condenser, evaporator, expansion valve. The flow of refrigerant is controlled by expansion valve. Third question, the moisture in the refrigerant is removed by evaporator, safety relief valve, expansion valve, dryers. The moisture in the refrigerant is removed by dryers. Now the dryers are, here is fans. Fourth question, the refrigerant for a refrigerator should have high sensible heat, high total heat, high latent heat, low latent heat. Fourth one, answer is high latent heat. Fifth question, the domestic refrigerator uses following type compressor: centrifugal, axial, miniature sealed unit, position type reciprocating. The answer is position type reciprocating. Sixth one, the vapor pressure of refrigerant should be lower than atmospheric pressure, higher than atmospheric pressure, equal to atmospheric pressure, could be anything. The answer is higher than atmospheric pressure, then only it can absorb the heat. Seventh one, in a refrigeration system, the expansion device is connected between compressor and condenser, condenser and receiver, receiver and evaporator, evaporator and compressor. The answer is receiver and evaporator. The condition of refrigerant after passing through the condenser in a vapor compression system is, options are saturation liquid, wet vapor, dry saturation vapor, superheated vapor. Answer is saturation liquid. Where does the lowest temperature occur in the vapor compression cycle? Options are compressor, condenser, evaporator, expansion valve. Answer is evaporator. In a vapor compression system, the condition of refrigerant before passing through a condenser is saturated liquid, wet vapor, dry saturated vapor, superheated vapor. The answer is superheated vapor. Here is the answers for above MCQs. Thank you, my dear students. Please write any suggestions to the below gmail lms.dtek@gmail.com. Thank you once again.